So we've finally got a name for Breath of the Wild's long-awaited sequel, Tears of the Kingdom. Along with it, we got a little over a minute of new footage, some cryptic shots of ancient stone carvings, then a few final clips of Link exploring Hyrule and the skies above it. Let's take a closer look and try and break this all down. The trailer begins with a stone carving of a strange figure. We can only really see its long neck and head, but we get a much better look at it later, so I'll come back to it. Next is another carving, this time showing an army of moblins and bokoblins seemingly advancing on a wave of malice, the dark red energy of Calamity Ganon. Outside of the malice wave are ranks of soldiers, each wearing what looks like robes, and each holding a sword and a shield. Some of the soldiers can be seen inside the malice, most standing like the others, but one can be seen presumably dead on the floor. We don't know who these soldiers are, perhaps they're related to the mysterious Zonai, or perhaps they're depictions of ancient Hyrulean soldiers, but what's clear is that this carving depicts a battle long ago against an army of Ganon's minions. Next up, a better look at the figure from the beginning. This time we can see the whole thing. It appears to be standing on a platform, and we can see that, although it doesn't look human, it has human-like arms which it holds outstretched. Its design is somewhat reminiscent of the Lord of the Mountain, a being strongly connected to spirits and to resurrection, and it's surrounded by seven symbols, which could well be a depiction of the seven sages. It's definitely positioned like a deity or religious figure, and surrounding it are depictions of clouds. Considering that it's standing on a platform, it's a safe guess to assume that this stone carving shows the being standing on one of the floating sky islands far above Hyrule. Following this is a carving of a figure seemingly levitating in the air. The figure has long hair and wears robes, and the way it's positioned definitely suggests that this could be a depiction of the body of Ganondorf, seen all the way back in the game's reveal trailer. Strengthening this idea is the fact that we can see malice creeping up from just below the figure, just like how malice surrounds Ganondorf's body. The final carving shown in the trailer shows another figure with long hair, this time almost certainly depicting Princess Zelda, with pointed Hylian ears and a dress much like Zelda's white one. She's holding out her hand, which is cupped into another hand, though we can't quite see whose just yet, but we get a better look later on. It's interesting that, if this is Zelda, she has long hair here, when in all trailers for the game so far, she's had it cut short. On the right side of the frame is a group of glyphs, the same symbols we've seen repeatedly throughout the game's trailers, in the swirling green energy and carved into the stone of the Sky Islands. Next up, we see Link throw open two huge stone doors, notably marked with the symbol of two dragons making a ring. This symbol also appears in the game's logo, so we'll talk about it more later on, but there's no doubt that the design of the dragons matches that of Zonai architecture, the mysterious, ancient ruins of an advanced magical civilization who vanished suddenly thousands of years before Breath of the Wild. Who the Zonai are and why they vanished is still a complete mystery. I've made videos in the past talking about them, so it'll be great to finally get some more information on them. Link runs through the stone doors and out into a shrine-like area of one of the Sky Islands, identical to the ones we've seen before in previous trailers. There's then a cut before Link jumps off the edge into the open sky, where we get a good look at our hero. He's almost exactly the same as he appeared back in previous trailers, with the strange corrupted right arm, new shield and new outfit, but on his left hip we can spot what looks like small vials, glowing the same blue-green colour as the spectral hand from the first trailer, Link's hand in the second trailer, and the energy that appears when he uses his new jumping ability. So perhaps these are used to store whatever this energy is. The camera pans around and we get a look at Link's surroundings, what looks like a frozen area on his right, and a huge amount of islands out in front. There's the same tower structure seen in the last trailer, islands again covered in little shrines and golden trees, and though it's very hard to make out, there's a dragon flying in the distance. It's serpentine like Breath of the Wild's three dragons, but its colours don't match up to any of Nedra, Dinral and Farosh, which means that we're more than likely going to meet entirely new dragons in Hyrule's skies. Breath of the Wild's dragons are known as the Servants of the Springs, mysterious beings somehow connected to the goddesses. Considering how much the dragon symbol has appeared throughout trailers, it makes a lot of sense that dragons make a return in this game. Link jumps off the island into a dive, then transitions mid-fall into having his arms outstretched. This matches one of the patents filed by Nintendo for game mechanics, which also include details on how his jumping ability works and how aerial combat could function with the bow. Next, Link is seen using his ability to reverse time for an object on a chunk of stone bearing Zonai markings, pulling it up out of a body of water surrounded by Zonai pillars. We've previously seen him use this ability to throw back a spiked ball back up a hill at a group of enemies, but this time, he starts the stone moving upwards, jumps onto it, and rides it up into the sky. This is an awesome way to reach the floating sky island, and it makes sense. We can see rubble in previous trailers that matches the stone of the islands littered across Hyrule, stone that has presumably fallen from the sky. So, by reversing this fall, Link can ride the rubble back up to where it fell from. This also means that Link will probably only be able to perform jumps like this using objects that have previously fallen from the sky to Hyrule's surface, limiting the amount of ways he'll be able to reach the islands. Also of note is the fact that the group of islands floating in the distance are engulfed in a thunderstorm, perhaps posing a challenge for Link to reach. Here, Link climbs up a tree root clinging to the side of a sky island. He's wearing the loose cloth outfit we've seen before, though this time has a new weapon. A very primitive looking axe made of stone and carved bone. It's interesting that he's climbing up the tree root. Perhaps it's just for the sake of the trailer, or maybe Link won't be able to climb the smooth stone surface of some of the sky islands, just like how he can't climb the smooth stone in Sheikah shrines. The final shot of the trailer before the logo reveal has Link again diving from the sky. At the top of the frame, we can spot the very bottom of an island and a large number of islands in the distance. We can also see Hyrule Castle levitating on a geyser of malice, just like we saw at the end of the E3 2021 trailer, but malice also seems to be pouring out of Death Mountain. Perhaps whatever happened underground with Ganondorf's body has caused malice to erupt from anywhere it can, bursting out of Hyrule's underground and corrupting the surface. Link continues his fall until he's picked up by a stone bird, which matches some of the stonework seen on the islands and the design of the strange golem seen in a previous trailer, and uses it to glide above the Tabantha Bridge stable. On the ground here, we can see a couple of interesting details. Firstly, a spiral of green energy swirling just like in the first trailer. I went to this exact spot on Breath of the Wild, and interestingly, the spiral seems to be coming up from a Bokoblin skull camp. Considering that the first spiral was connected to Ganondorf's body, might it be the spirits of the dead? And we can see a symbol on the mountain Link seems to be gliding towards. If we rotate it, we can see that it's another depiction of the strange being seen at the very beginning, connecting it to the blue-green energy. With that, we finally move to the game's logo reveal. Two Zonai dragons, again glowing that same eerie green, come together to form a circle, similar to the symbol seen on the giant doors earlier on, and eat each other's tails. This is incredibly reminiscent of an Ouroboros, an ancient symbol depicting a dragon or serpent eating its own tail, which represents the eternal cycle of life and death, of prosperity and destruction. Considering the seemingly endless cycles of great calamities faced by the Kingdom of Hyrule, and that we appear to be discovering ancient secrets about the realm's history, this is a very fitting symbol, suggesting that the game's story will focus on Hyrule's endless cycle of hope and destruction. This fits with the game's subtitle, Tears of the Kingdom, which obviously connotes the feelings of anguish and sorrow caused by Hyrule's endless suffering, but also could connect back to the teardrop-shaped liquid seen in the first trailer, just before Link performs his jump. Another possibility is that the symbols seen on the stone carvings surrounding the strange figure, and again above the title here, could be these tears. Also worth noting is that the Master Sword in the game's logo is broken, just like we saw in previous clips, though the missing end has been restored with green energy. Now, though the logo obscures most of it, the trailer ends like it began, with a stone carving. It's a full look at the previous one that seemed to depict Princess Zelda holding her hand up alongside another figure, which here we can see is the mysterious figure seen at the very beginning. With very little context, it's difficult to guess at who this figure is. We see them in a position of meditation or embrace on a stone platform, arms outstretched, and again holding its hand up to what might be Zelda. There's the possibility that this might be the being to which the spectral glowing hand belongs, seen in the first trailer for the game. It's connected to the green energy, as seen on the mountaintop, to the Zonai, as seen by the carvings, and possibly to the Seven Sages and to Princess Zelda too. So, could this strange being be what was holding Ganondorf imprisoned? What caught Link and Zelda as they fell? And what has given Link his new powers and new right arm? From the very first trailer for Tears of the Kingdom, we knew that we were going back to the origins of the Great Calamity, uncovering dark secrets from Hyrule's past. We've seen the emaciated body of Ganondorf imprisoned deep underground, what might be the beginnings of Hyrule's cycles of endless torment. The Ouroboros symbol represents this cycle, a cycle which might finally be coming to an end. Thanks for watching this initial analysis of the Tears of the Kingdom trailer. Of course, it's only been a few hours since the trailer dropped, so I'm sure there's a lot that I've missed, but this isn't the only video I'll make on this. I'll be posting more analyses and theories on the game in the next few weeks, so subscribe for more. And if you noticed anything I didn't, or have any theories on the game, let me know in the comments down below. Cheers guys, and I'll see you next time.